Who here has heard of the Alhambra? Okay. So the Alhambra is a palace and a fortress located in Granada, Spain. According to Britannica.com, the name Alhambra signifies the red in Arabic and is probably derived from the reddish color of the tapia, which is rammed earth of which the outer walls were built. Oh, then that's it. So the Alhambra was actually built by Muhammad I in Granada, Spain during the 13th century on Roman fortifications. It was built at first as a fortress. And so after Muhammad I, Muhammad II and III continued building it as a fortress. And so it wasn't until, oh, I messed up. Okay. And so it wasn't until Yusuf I and Muhammad V actually changed it into a palace. And so I am credible to speak about the Alhambra because I actually visited it and I actually did extensive research for the speech. I visited it last summer and did the tour and everything. So the purpose of the speech is to inform you guys a little bit about the place and its background. And during this speech, I will talk about the background, the place itself, and its structures, and also the legends that come with it. So like I said, it was built by the Moorish monarchs in Granada during the 13th century. And so during Muhammad I, II, and III, it was used as a fortress until Yusuf I and Muhammad V turned it into a palace. Yeah. And according to SpanishWars.net, the Emirate of Granada was the only flaw in Isabel and Ferdinand's perfect marriage. Because before Ferdinand and Isabella took over Spain, Granada was the only city that was left during the Spanish Reconquista, so like they were the last ones before they fully took over. And so that to them was pretty bad because they were the only ones resisting their power. And so in April 1491, the Catholic monarch decided to seize Granada. And so since Granada didn't have a coastline, they couldn't receive any resources to actually be able to beat them. And so in January 1492, Granada surrendered to the Catholics. And so that is what we see here. This is the king walking down from the palace, and so giving the key to the city to the king and queen. And so now that I've just talked about a little bit of the background, I'm gonna move on to talk about the structures it has. And so the Alhambra measures in total 142,000 square meters in total. And so it is a pretty big place, and there are many different parts to it, but the three main parts are the four palaces and the general life, which includes gardens, fountains, waterways. And so according to Khan Academy, the Alhambra is distinct among medieval palaces for its sophisticated planning and complex decorative programs, its many enchanting gardens and fountains. And so the palaces. This is the first palace that I researched, and it is called the Comares Palace. And the way you could distinguish it from the rest of the palaces is because of the reflecting pool that it has here. It actually contains the largest tower in the whole entire thing. And fun fact, the way you could distinguish towers from being Moorish or Catholic is because the Moorish towers are square-shaped and then the Catholic towers are circle-shaped. And so this is the second palace. It's called the Palace of the Palace Alliance, and so you can distinguish it by this fountain right here, which contains stone lions with the fountain on its back, and then this is called the Sister Room, and then the Sala de Abercenajes, and then we'll learn a little bit more about the sala in a bit. And so this is the Pardo Palace, and the way you can distinguish this one is because of the five arches that it has, and it is actually the oldest palace that's there. And so this is the last palace. After Queen Ferdinand and, no, King Ferdinand and Queen Isabella, Carlos V took over decades later, and so he decided to start creating his own palace. But before it was finished, he actually passed away, and so he didn't continue planning the way it was built. So that's why you see no roof on it, because he died too soon. Okay, and then the second main part is the general life, which you can see it has a whole bunch of fountains, gardens, and waterways. The Granada actually has a complex hydraulic system because it is, because since it was all the way on top, and so the kings didn't want to like go down to like find water. And so, okay, yeah. And so now that I've just talked about the little structures that the Alhambra has, I'm going to move on to talk about the general life. So the Alhambra has, I'm gonna go ahead and talk about the legend, sorry. So there was two legends that I learned about while I was there. The first one was actually the Sala Versinacas, which you see here. How many of you guys have seen Game of Thrones? A lot of you guys. Okay, so the first time I went here, the Versinacas was a family that lived in Granada, and so the kings, the Sultan of Granada was jealous of them because the main guy from the Versinacas was supposedly having an affair. Okay, it's okay.
I'm sorry.
It's okay, no worries.